Lord, won't you buy me a Mercedes Benz? My friends all drive Porsches. I must make amends. Worked hard all my lifetime. No help from my friends. So, oh Lord, won't you buy me a Mercedes?
When you're replacing the pads on your car, you need to measure the thickness of your rotor to make sure that it's within spec. And measuring this rotor, I find that it's not within spec. It's too thin, and it's too thin by quite a large amount. On a 1984 car, the minimum thickness for rotors, both front and rear, is 866 thousandths or 22 millimeters. That is a wear limit. A minimum thickness after machining, if you have them turned, would be 890 thousandths or 22.6 millimeter, and brand new is typically around 945 thousand or around 24 millimeter. So I checked my front rotors. After finding these rotors were thin, I checked my front rotors and they're very nearly new. They're in excellent condition and they're a lot thicker than what the rear ones are. So I'm going to assume that some previous owner has replaced the front ones and didn't bother to do the back when he should have. So we're going to stop my pad job until I get my new rotors in, and we will have a little session on how to replace the rotors. When you want to remove this disc, you have to remove two screws which are here and here. Now give them a little shot of penetrating oil, and quite often these are corroded and don't want to come out. So we have what's known as a hammer impact. You put that baby in there, give that a smack, and they come loose just like that. And I gotta rock that to get it out, but that screw is now loose and will come out no problem. So that's really the right way to break those free. These are cheap, you can buy them anywhere, and they work great. In order to remove the rear disc from your car, you need to remove the brake caliper. In order to remove the brake caliper, you need to remove this hard line and two bolts, top and bottom. When you do that, brake fluid is going to want to drain down through. Now the way to stop that is to go inside your car and press the brake pedal down about an inch or so and use a brake stop to hold it there, or stuff a piece of wood in there or whatever, but that will stop your fluid from draining through and you'll be good to go. After you remove your two screws, your disc should just come off. Now, if it won't come off, then it's probably your inside parking brake that is too tight out this way. And you can loosen that up by turning your largest hole all the way to the back. Look in here with a flashlight. If you look in here with a flashlight, you will find an adjuster on your parking brake, and you insert a screwdriver and you can loosen that adjuster by moving your screwdriver to the front in this manner, and you loosen it until you can pull your disc off. When you're all done, you need to retighten it by going the opposite way, like this. And that will turn that adjuster. Now, if you still can't get it off, then there's a threaded hole here and here. You put a little bolt in there. I think it's 10 millimeter. And you screw those bolts in, and that will jack that disc away. And we'll see what happens. I think mine's going to come right off, just like that. Beautimus.